Namaste student, today we are going to see the chapter statistics. Here we have the definition, statistics. Statistics is defined as the science of collection, organization, presentation, analyze and interpretation of data. So here, why they are using science? What does it mean science? Science has lots of definition. One definition is that systematic knowledge, that is called science. So here we're going to see first data. Here, what does it mean data? Data means raw facts and figure. Data is a plural form, raw facts and figure. That means your data should be facts and it must be numerical value. That means 1, 2, 3, 2.5, 6, root, anything. But remember, it should not be any name. Name should not be there. Okay. Now, this data can be collected in two ways. One is primary data. That is collection of data. First step is our collection of data. And this can be collected two ways. One is primary data. That means directly collected. So what does it mean directly collected? Okay, we'll see. Another is secondary data. That is indirectly collected. Let's try to understand with the help of example. Like, if I'll ask you or take this person and there is another person sitting on the chair. Okay. He asked this person to collect the weight of the students of class 10. Now, she has collected the data. For her, whatever observation, whatever data has been collected, that is primary data. For whom? For this person. Now, if she give it to this person, then that data, right now it is primary. That means directly collected. Now, this person pass the data to this person. For him, whatever data has been collected, that is secondary data, indirectly collected. Okay. Now, this data are not arranged. We need to arrange first in ascending or descending. So, is it necessary? Yes, if you'll arrange anything, that you can make some type of formulas and maths discuss and deal with this formula. Okay, arrangement is very much necessary. So here, another term is array. Array means arranged data. That may be ascending, order or descending order. Okay. Now after arranging, you can see that data can be kept in a group or you can keep the data in ungrouped. Group means, like if I collect few student here, their weights. Okay. So how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Take 10 students. Now if we'll arrange the data such a way that in first group will be what? 30 kg to 40 kg person. Second group, 40 to 50 kg person. And in the third group, 50 to 60 kg person. And to arrange in this group, first we need to get the range. Range means minimum value, and there should be difference between minimum value and maximum value. Okay, range we need. So that will be difference, maximum value. So we are using mod here, we'll get positive. Okay, now if this person has 60 kg, 65 kg, this one has 50 kg, 55 kg, 45 kg, 35 kg, 40 kg, 48 kg, 39 kg, and 30 kg. Okay. So here we are going to organize this one. We're going to arrange it in a group data. So here you can see that 30 to 40 kg person, how many are there? And remember, your 40 will not repeat. So here in group, we can keep the person in a which from, exclusive from. This is called exclusive from. If we'll keep the person in this order, like 30 to 39, 40 to 49, 50 to 59, and if there is any 60, yes, there is a 60 also. So we are keeping 60 to 70 kg, and here 60 to 69. Okay, now you can see that this one is in inclusive form. Okay, and this one we call class interval. First class interval, second class interval, third class, fourth. Similarly here, class interval, first class, second, third, fourth. In each class interval, there is upper limit. This is your upper limit, this is your lower limit, or we call lower boundary, upper boundary. Okay. Now if we're going to keep the person in this form, you can see that your 40 repeats 2 times. But if you see in this group, you can see that upper boundary and lower boundary are not same. But here you can see that upper boundary for the first interval and lower boundary for the second interval are same. So shall I keep the person who is 40 kg in both the group? No. Then in which group we are going to keep? We keep that person in the second group. We'll not going to take any numbers, any person which is exactly 40, exactly 50, exactly 60. We'll shift in the next succeeding class interval. Okay, so here if we'll count, let's see, 30 to 40 kg, how many person are there? 30, 39, is there any more? 35. There are 3 person. So this is called frequency. Okay, how many? 3. 3 frequency means the frequency 3. That means there are 3 persons who are in between 30 to 40. Okay, next 40 to 50. So we are going to take the 40 person kg weight in this category. That is 1, 2, 3, yes, 3 member here also. That means frequency of this class interval is 3. Next we'll proceed. How many? For 50 to 60. So let's count. 1, 2. Is there any more? No. 2. Next for the last category we have 1, 2. So we'll take here 2. Now if we'll add here, you will get 10, and it must be equals to the number of total person, that is called total frequency should match. Total how many members? Have you seen 10? That means frequency should be 10. Here also we'll get same number of frequency, means total frequency will be 10. But let's check that this will be same or not. For 30 to 39, yes, 2 person are there, 1 and 2, and more, 3. So 3 is same, no problem. Another one, 40, 48, 45. Here also we are getting same, no problem. Next, 52, this one, we are getting same thing here, 2. And 62, yes, here also same. Now the question will arise, sir, if there is a 59, think about this one is your 59. If the 59 will be there, shall I take 59? Yes, you need to take 59. Why, sir? Because you can see that the 59 is not repeating in this category or in this class interval. That's why you need to take the 59 in this category. Remember. Okay. Now we'll proceed for presentation. So here the first one, see, collection, organization, and third one is presentation. So here the presentation, we have two presentation. One is tabular presentation. Okay. In tabular presentation, for class 9 we have what frequency distribution table, or sometime we have telemarks table also. Okay, in tabular presentation we are going to try to solve the problem, and we keep it in a table form. Whenever we are going to analyze any data or data, that is your mean, median, mode, standard deviation, then variance, there are so many. Just in our syllabus we have only 3, that is mean, median, and mode. Okay, for class 9 we have mean, median, mode for ungrouped data, and for class 10 we have mean, median, mode for group data. Okay, for class 10, and other concept will remain same. So here in tabular presentation we need to make a table like that. This is a tabular presentation, and to analyze the data, this is the fourth one, to analyze the data we use tabular presentation. Okay, it helps us lots. Now second one is graphical presentation. The graphical means after completing your tabular part, after analyzing the tabular part or analyzing the data, after analyzing the data you need to keep this one in a graphical presentation. Right now class 9 have frequency polygon, histogram, bar graph, and the pie chart were there in class 8 or 7. Okay, right now this one, histogram and frequency polygon. For class 10 we have ogive curve, pronunciation is ogive curve. Okay, and for median only this one we have. Okay, this is for median. Okay, now in analyzation of data, that means analyzation means what, sir? After getting your data in a group or ungrouped data, there are lots of information in there. Lots of information means lots of data. We don't need that many data. Like if I'll have right now, I have only 10 persons data. Now if if I'll take the whole school's data, that means more than 3,000 students are there, and if I'll take all the data and anyone will going to give me that one and ask me to find the average, it's very difficult now. Okay, we are arranging in a grouped order. After arranging, we're analyzing average. Now after getting that average, just if I'll give you the exact one value, you can understand, you can interpret many things from a single data. That's why in analyzation of data, we have this tree as a central tendency. That means it gives you compact answer of the whole data. Now, in the median mode, here they have only single formula right now. And we have in ascending order formula. Okay, whatever formula we have in our syllabus, that is for ascending order group data. Now for mean, we have three more method. That is direct method, assuming method, step deviation method. Okay, for class 10, we have only for class 9, we have only direct method for ungrouped data. We're going to see that one. Okay, after getting the analyzation of data, we're going to conclude, we'll get some result from the information. That is called interpretation of data. This is means statistics. Okay, I hope you understood. Thank you.